You know, every choreographer's process is different, and I found that from the very beginning, I wasn't so experimental, and I came to learn that I couldn't just improvise in front of a group, that I needed to know the situation really well. I needed to do a lot of pre-production, and sometimes pre-production is just like plastering my office walls with what the people's clothing would be, like understanding clothing, understanding shoes. Like if I'm choreographing something in the 40s and everybody's smoking, how does a certain character hold their cigarette? So all those hours of forethought and planning are integral to my work, but also I really enjoy that part of the process. So when I took up this challenge of staging ballet, I spent a couple weeks in New York City, first a week with just myself in the dance studio, and then I spent a week with 10 dancers to really experiment with things that are new to me. Like if this is a joyful expression, what lift feels like this moment, or what percussive idea feels like this other moment. And that time with the dancers is very educational to me, because then I feel like I know the product well enough that I can come into this room with these exceptional dancers who bring another whole bag of tricks. I mean, they have such expertise that they're gonna take my blueprint and then fill it. But I feel a slight bit nervous, but also irresponsible if I don't come into the room with a blueprint. I think for me, one of the biggest differences of choreographing in this environment to a stage musical is that there's a wonderful limbo that happens in a musical where the scene work has to bridge a more heightened vocabulary. So like the scene has to say something so vital that you could only go further in song or dance. And so the emotion has to be really, really rich. And I spend a lot of time walking that limbo of pedestrian movement clicking into a choreographic vocabulary. And here, all the tools are bigger. So it's not a person speaking and then heightening. It's already heightened and then has to heighten further into dance. And so for me, where like an actor might scream like, I'm angry at something, like what is our dance version of I'm angry at something? And so it is a slightly new mindset for me, because I'm used to speaking, driving in to the bigger idea. But it's exciting because these dancers have such a huge repertoire. I can think of an idea, like I can just whip my head, but they're gonna do it with their leg. And so like that's really exciting for me to say, this is what I think it is, and then all of a sudden they bring a bag of tricks to it that is more colorful than I could have imagined. I did a show a couple years ago on Broadway called Bandstand, and it was about these World War II vets coming home. And I had my eyes opened to Americana in a way that I hadn't before. I feel like I'm a generous person in terms of my spirit, but I love the Norman Rockwell-esque period of The Greatest Generation. And I think that that is a building block of our culture, and that was a dynamic time. So even though that's not what this piece is about, this piece still centers around The Greatest Generation. It centers around the sacrifices we made as Americans to have a home, to have a family. And so that sense of love, which matches the strength of duty, is something that I feel we do well as a country. And that's what this piece is much about. It's about a person who is so in love that he's conflicted between duty and love in his mind and in his heart. But also there's real romance about the piece. And so I think that there's a challenge, a wonderful challenge, to tell a story that has complex subtext, but at the same time has a romance about it that every person can relate to and say, I know what it feels to be looked at like that, or I know what it feels to want to hold somebody like that. So that sense of sweeping romance, I think we need to keep telling those stories. We need to keep telling stories where the heart wins, where romance makes people be able to fly, and also where, whether you're American or not American, there's the sense of, I believe this is for me and I'm willing to fight for it. That sense of fight, I think, is an exciting subject.